this is my kind of place. I think it's a lot of fun when you can have a product like a See's candy or Coca-Cola, whatever. But you really love the product itself. I just like to eat, and especially candy.
When I was six, we're talking 1936 now, I got a nickel a week allowance. And we would go up to Ernie's drugstore. There they would have penny candy. So the nickel would entitle me to five choices. And I could spend an hour making those choices.
Peanut brittle is my favorite.
Well, I like the peanut brittle a lot. And there's no way to stop once you start eating peanut brittle.
Oh, Cracker Jack's
prize. Yeah, they have a prize in every box. Yeah, Cracker Jack's.
And that's one of those things where they managed to get the salt and the sugar mix where you just keep eating because it's salty and sugary.
Yeah, I got addicted to these kind of things. And Whoppers I love. I mean, I can eat those. And Mouth Duds. Mouth Duds we used to.
How about dark chocolate? What do you think of that?
Well, I like almost everything. just offer it to me and find out.
This is unbelievable.
Oh, I claim to be pretty good at pinball.
I bought a machine for $25 in 1946. Built a small empire out of it. It was the best business I was ever in. I peaked very early in my business career. It's been all downhill ever since.
So this article is the start of the personal computing industry. This really cheap kit computer appeared on the cover of this magazine. And we saw it in December 74. And then Paul was saying, okay, you've got to drop out. We've got to start Microsoft. This is going to happen without us. And in fact, this company who made this, they became our first customer.
That is something. I'd heard the story, but I'd never seen the magazine before. And frankly, if I read it, I wouldn't have known what to do with it. This is a book that first came out in 1949, The Intelligent Investor by Ben Graham. When I read this book, it changed my life. Anytime the market takes a sharp dive, and you get tempted to sell or something, just pull out this book and reread it.
Warren made his first trip to Hawaii when I got married, and Melinda's gift to me was that she had Willie Nelson come and sing the night before the wedding. So this has got special history for me.
When I was a kid, the big thing to do was listen to your hit parade. Presented by Lucky Strike, be happy, go lucky, and they would start with number 10 to work their way up to number one. And Glenn Miller was probably number one. There's a Glenn Miller.
Here we go.
Yeah, and I can probably hum any one of those songs on there. Dum 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 dum. I'll take the whole place. Let's just get it all.
Here we are.
Hello.
Ready to go.
Ready to work.
We got the wrong name tags on.
This is just a sample of our competence. If you think this is bad, wait till we really get into action.
Yeah, just fill it up to that.
Whoa.
Well, keep it going. You got to get two balls on there.
But I'll see if I can do better.
Oh my God.
See, I'm very jealous.
They're going to order from you from now on, not from me. Who had the bad luck to draw me? If you want anything later on, it's on me.
The cone is okay.
You guys want to learn how to help customers?
You bet.
A vanilla cone.
A vanilla cone? Is that all you want today?
That'll do it.
Let's upsell her.
You didn't do anything wrong. It's just taking some time. So that barks at us a little
bit. I'm a slow customer. It's okay.
Thank you. Have you been to Dairy Queen before?
Do you want a dip or not dip?
Can I have a triple chocolate brownie?
That is really one of our best items.
In fact, if you don't eat it, we will.
All right, what else?
I'm going to keep it simple and go banana split, please.
Okay, that's
a double banana split?
Yes, sir.
You're a real man.
All right, what would you like?
I want a Oreo Blizzard.
Oh, that's one of our most popular. What else can we do?
I want a medium Reese's Blizzard.
OK.
Okay.
It's very popular.
Is it?
Yeah, absolutely.
I like that peanut butter.
Extra peanut butter for him.
Okay, so the three most important things about training somebody new. Number one is definitely patience.
I'll put the hand out for the money and Bill can do the high-tech stuff.
You still gotta ask her what she wants for her dipping sauce.
You dip chicken too? Wow, you guys dip a lot of stuff around here.
Number two, make sure you smile so they should smile, you know, kind of pass the smiles along.
We got it.
Smile.
Three, have a good time and treat a customer like there's somebody that's in your own home.
Whoa! You get two free ones for that.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I like that. I like that.
Thank you.
Much better than the way I did it.
Yeah, how long ago did you buy Dairy Queen, and what was it that made it look good?
I've known Dairy Queen all my life. Dairy Queen actually started in the 1930s. A couple guys worked up soft ice cream, and when they were contemplating selling, he thought of Berkshire. Who better than some guy that loved the product, and we made a deal, and we've lived happily ever after.
So how did Bill and Warren do today?
Could have done better. Bill was good on the menu board. Warren was good at taking credit. So, but all around, they did all right. I'd hire them.
Hi, welcome to Dairy Queen. Can I take your order?
I'll have a small Oreo Blizzard.
That'll be $3.23. Can you pull forward to the next window? Okay.
Oh, wow.
That is for you.
Good job on this one.
Love to have you here. Thank you.
See you. So how did this all get started?
It got started by a woman. Her name was Rose Blumkin. Came to the country in 1917. When she got to be 89, she decided she was going to sell the store and there were some other people interested. And she said, no, I'm going to sell to Mr. Buffett. She lived to 104. When she got to be 103, she retired. I mean, I just wish Mrs. B was around to see this today. I
mean, yeah, you know, how well it's done.
It just
takes. So this is July 5th, 1991. We didn't know why we were meeting each other until we met each other.
Exactly.
We thought our domains did not overlap.
Right.
But the domain of trying to understand how the world works and what was going on, we both found each other's way of looking at that so fascinating that they had to tear us apart and we became
Good friends
as of that day.
My real vocational goal was to be a mattress tester. I mean, right. I thought that would be a terrific job. I just test mattresses all day, but I never got that. But they did make a mattress after me, the Warren. Well, there we go. Touting.
Pretty nice.
Can you imagine this? I mean, this is the way to spend your time.
I think this is better than the mattress I sleep on.
I wouldn't fool around with computers when I could be in this position. I mean,
can you remember buying your first mattress, Lawrence?
Well, I didn't do very much of the purchasing in our family. I can't recall ever buying anything, actually. Check this man's credit and see if he's good. Being successful at almost anything means having a passion for it. If you see somebody with even reasonable intelligence and a terrific passion for what they do and who can get people around them to march even when those people can't see over the top of the next hill, things are going to happen.
You know, building Microsoft was incredibly fun. And because we were right about software, we had the wind at our back. And so when I got into philanthropy, the idea of could I do it twice, you know, in an area where the feedback isn't quite as obvious of what you're doing right and wrong, now I can say that we've got this organization that is so much fun to be a part of. So it's not only a great organization, but it's got these metrics that, at least on some of them, we've exceeded our own expectations. How do we get out of here?
Well, we don't want you to get out of here. It's well designed in that respect.
It's like a casino.
But let me get oriented now. And the truth is, I don't know where we are.
When you bought it, it wasn't...